about 5 or 6 times in size, copy and pasted it into the set in post-production, and that created our beautiful Kratos scene set that you see in the films. Now, from something that isn't real, to something that most definitely is, the floor. In fact, if you give me a little stamp on that floor, just double check that for me. Because that is really old flagstone, and you'll find that in almost any castle it was visited in the UK. Now, on the very first Harry Potter floor, the filmmakers realised that the floor was going to go through quite a lot of wear and tear. So, using real stone was going to be the best option available to them. And it did survive some of the biggest scenes in our film series, the biggest one being most definitely the sorting ceremony that you can see in the first Harry Potter floor, the Philosopher's Stone. And with the sorting ceremony in mind, we have our four Hogwarts houses here on display. We have, of course, half and half to my left. To the opposite, then, is Ravenclaw. To the right, then, is Ravenclaw and Slytherin. And to my right, we have the House of My Heroes. And it's time to go with that as well. Now, just as Harry, Ron, and Hermione have done, we've walked through the Ravenclaw talks all the way through the central aisle. And we've made our way to the other side of the set, over to the teacher's table. And this, of course, is where our heroes are sorted into their houses by some of Britain's finest acting talent. One of which includes this lovely gentleman right here, Robbie Coltrane, of course, playing Ruby's Hagrid. Now, one last thing for you is this. Robbie Coltrane never actually wore this particular costume. Now, Robbie's quite tall man. He's down to around about 6'2", which is the exact same height as Alan Rubin, who plays Severus Snape. But that's not quite tall enough to play our 7'6" half giant. So this costume was worn by his size double, a man from Martin Baker, who's an ex-even rugby player, and he's down to around about 6'10", which is about there, I think, as you can see, we're not quite there yet, so we have to have some solution costume to get it up that height. Part of our first costume as well, and they even put a Coltrane head on the top of his head to make it look exactly like Robert Coltrane. And he can blink his eyes, blink his eyebrows, open and talk his mouth as well, all kind of manner of different things. And you'll get a chance to see that head later on in the Christmas part, so I'm not sure if you can get out of that. Now, in the meantime, unfortunately, the time for Brexit is starting to come to an end, but there are just a couple of things we need to mention before you head onwards. Now, if anyone here has a studio tour passport, you're looking at the 7 staffing locations as well as 16 golden stitches. Now, the first stitch you're going to find above the left hand arch over there, you make your way outside if you want. And your first stop of the day, you're going to find in about 10 minutes' time while you're doing the conference. So look out for all those as you go around the tour. If you have a digital guide with the green landmark, you're looking at the number of studio tour icons.
What is it?
I'm just stopping. Oh, I love you.
playing.
Daddy will carry you.
¿Sabes que había un rollo en la piedra?
you make... Stand closer, so you get to see it properly. Where's Kai? Stand here in the middle. Closer.
Yeah.
It's not good, but the fire will not reach you because it's on the screen. Go closer because I cannot see you on the camera.
So this is now Cash.
Hogwarts Castle.
This is the Hogwarts Castle.